Have you ever wondered how iron is obtained? That metal that holds up skyscrapers, colossal bridges, and heavy machinery? Today, we'll take you deep into the earth and inside the industrial process to discover how one of the most important materials of modern civilization is born. Iron is the most abundant metal on the planet and a vital part of Earth's core. It represents more than 90% of all refined metal in the world, used mainly to produce steel, the material that changes everything. Its resistance to heat. It melts at around 1,500 degrees Celsius, makes it the perfect foundation for durable structures. And if its strength impresses you, imagine this. Steel can be up to 1,000 times stronger than pure iron. But that's not all. Iron is also magnetic, a vital property for electric motors, magnets, and electronic devices. Its main minerals, hematite and magnetite, are extracted in massive mining operations. Today, China leads the world in both production and consumption of iron. And the best part? Iron is 100% recyclable, a true silent hero of the circular economy. In this video, we'll explore step by step how raw rock transforms into monumental structures. So if you love the science behind everyday things, subscribe, like, and share this video. And tell us in the comments, what surprised you most about iron? Let's begin this metallic adventure. Step 1. Extraction of iron ore from open pit or underground mines. The journey to obtain iron begins beneath the Earth's surface, in vast reserves of hematite and magnetite, the two main iron ores. To extract them, two primary methods are used: open pit mining and underground mining, depending on the depth and quality of the deposit. Open pit mines are the most common, as they allow large quantities of earth to be excavated efficiently. Massive terraced cuts are made into the ground using heavy machinery such as excavators, electric shovels, and large haul trucks. This method is preferred when the ore is relatively close to the surface. However, when deposits are located deep underground, subsurface mining is used. This involves constructing tunnels and galleries to reach the ore with greater precision, although it comes with higher operational costs and risks. Once extracted, the ore is transported to processing plants, where the next step begins: crushing and grinding. This initial stage is crucial, marking the start of a chain of processes that will transform raw rock into one of the most essential materials of modern industry. Step 2. Crushing and grinding the ore to facilitate processing. Once the iron ore has been extracted, it is not yet ready for the blast furnace. It must first be reduced to a smaller and more uniform size. This is where crushing and grinding come into play, a key step to optimize the performance of the next stage, ore concentration. Crushing is carried out using large machines called jaw crushers or cone crushers, which break down the large rocks into smaller fragments, just a few centimeters in diameter. These fragments are then fed into industrial mills, where the grinding process reduces the material to a fine powder. This stage aims to liberate the iron particles contained within the rock from the unwanted minerals or gangue. The finer the powder, the greater the efficiency of the upcoming concentration methods such as magnetic separation or flotation. In addition, having a uniform particle size allows for better material utilization and reduces energy consumption in later stages. This process also includes screening and classification systems, which separate the fragments by size to ensure a more precise and controlled treatment. Step 3, ore concentration, separation of impurities. After the crushing and grinding stages, the next step is to separate the useful iron from the impurities, or gangue, the unwanted materials present in the rock. This process is known as ore concentration, and its goal is to increase the iron content of the material before it reaches the blast furnace. One of the most common methods is magnetic separation, which takes advantage of iron's strong attraction to magnets. In this method, the powdered ore passes through magnetic drums that retain the iron-rich particles while letting the rest pass through. In some cases, especially when the ore contains impurities such as silica or clay, the flotation process is used, a chemical method where reagents and water are added to make the valuable minerals float and separate for the waste material. Another technique, known as gravity separation, sorts particles according to their specific weight. This method is particularly useful when there is a significant difference between the density of the iron ore and that of the impurities. By the end of this stage, a high-grade iron concentrate is obtained, rich in metal content and ready to be reduced in the blast furnace to produce pig iron, the raw material used to make steel. Step 4. Ore reduction in blast furnaces, producing pig iron. In this crucial stage of the process, the concentrated ore is transformed into pig iron, a liquid form of iron with a high carbon content. This transformation takes place inside massive structures known as blast furnaces, which can exceed 30 meters in height and operate continuously for years. The blast furnace is charged in layers with three main materials: concentrated iron or coke, which acts as both fuel and reducing agent, and limestone, which helps remove impurities. As hot air, reaching temperatures of over 1,000 degrees Celsius, 1,800 degrees Fahrenheit, is blown in from the base of the furnace, a series of chemical reactions begins. The coke burns and produces carbon monoxide, which reacts with the iron oxides, reducing them and releasing metallic iron. At the same time, the molten limestone combines with impurities to form a layer called slag, which floats on top of the liquid iron and is later removed. The final product is molten pig iron, which collects at the bottom of the furnace. However, this iron is not pure. It contains up to 4% carbon, making it brittle. That's why it must be refined in the next stage to become high-quality steel. Step 5. Converting pig iron into steel in converters or electric furnaces. Once the molten pig iron is obtained from the blast furnace, it cannot be used directly in structures or machinery due to its high carbon content and other impurities. To transform it into a stronger and more versatile material, a refining process is carried out to produce steel. This process is mainly performed in two types of facilities: basic oxygen converters and electric arc furnaces. In the converter, pig iron is poured in along with pure oxygen, which is blown in at high pressure. The oxygen reacts with the carbon and other impurities, removing them as gases such as carbon dioxide. In electric arc furnaces, recycled scrap metal is used along with pig iron to produce steel. An electric arc, generated by electrodes, melts the material and allows for precise control over the final steel composition. The result of both processes is liquid steel with low carbon content, much more suitable for manufacturing high-strength products. This steel can then be treated, molded, and alloyed according to the specifications required for its final application, such as in bridge construction, heavy machinery, or vehicles. Step 6. Shaping steel into ingots, plates, or coils according to its final use. Once the steel has been refined in the furnaces, it is in a liquid state and must be transformed into more manageable shapes for further processing. This step involves shaping the steel, depending on the desired form for its final application. One of the most common methods is ingot casting, where molten steel is poured into large molds that allow the metal to cool and solidify. These ingots can later be used to produce large machinery components or structural elements. Another common method is casting steel into plates or coils, depending on its final use. Plates are large, flat pieces of steel used in the manufacture of heavy and large-scale products, such as building and bridge structures. Coils, on the other hand, are rolled forms of steel, ideal for the automotive industry or the production of appliances, as they allow for more efficient handling and processing. The shaping process is followed by controlled cooling to prevent defects in the material. After this stage, the steel is ready to undergo heat treatments and other forming processes that enhance its physical properties according to specific requirements. Step 7. Industrial applications, from bridges to heavy machinery. Once the steel has been shaped and treated, it enters the final stage of its productive life cycle, industrial applications. Thanks to its exceptional properties, high strength, durability, and flexibility, steel is used across a vast range of industries and applications. One of the most common uses of steel is in the construction of bridges and metal structures. Its ability to bear heavy loads and withstand extreme weather conditions makes it the ideal material for such infrastructure. Additionally, steel is widely used in the production of heavy machinery, such as excavators, cranes, tractors, and other construction equipment, where strong and durable components are essential. In the automotive industry, steel is employed in the manufacturing of cars and key vehicle components, providing the structural strength necessary for safety and functionality. It is also used in the aerospace industry for building airplanes and components due to its strength-to-weight ratio. Steel also finds applications in tools and industrial equipment, highlighting its versatility and its critical role in the global economy. And so, we reach the end of our journey on how iron is obtained and transformed into steel, a material essential for the development of infrastructure, machinery, and countless other applications that make the modern world possible. From the deep mines to massive bridges and heavy machinery components, steel remains the foundation of construction and industrial innovation. If you enjoyed this journey through the fascinating world of iron, Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. Your support is crucial for bringing you more interesting content like this. What other industrial processes would you like to explore in depth? Leave a comment, and we'll gladly cover it in the next video.